Ladies and gentlemen, with a new snapshot comes new technical changes. So in this video, we're going to take a look at news for advancement triggers, loot table functions, custom world generation, and more for snapshot 21w39a. If you've missed my main gameplay changes video, check it out right here. Let's dive in, starting with resource packs. The pack version is now 8 for resource packs. The user interface file inventory.png now contains an extra sprite for the thin layout version of the effects list in the inventory. For loot tables, there's a new function called set_potion. This is used to set the potion data of a potion item and has one parameter called ID, which is the ID of the potion in question. This is now also used in all the vanilla loot tables that include potions. There are a bunch of advancement system changes as well in 21w39a. To begin with, a couple of new triggers. Fall from height is triggered when a player lands after falling. There are three available conditions. Player checks the player the advancement triggered for. Start position is a location predicate for the last position before the fall started. And distance is a predicate for the distance between the start position and the player's position at the end of the fall. The second new trigger is called Ride Entity in Lava and triggers every tick when a player rides an entity in lava. It has three conditions, which are exactly the same as for the Fall from Height trigger, but the start position is the first position where the ridden entity was on lava, and the distance is to where the player is currently at. A change has also been made to an existing trigger. Nether Travel now has start position as well, renamed from Entered, and Exited has also been removed since it's identical to a location check on the player condition. The on-disk storage file format for chunks has also been changed in this version. The block states and palette have been moved to a container structure called block_state. Biome data has been moved into sections as well and now reside in a similar container structure called biomes. And the carving masks are now stored as an array of 64-bit integers instead of bytes. In news that might be interesting to some modders and server owners, the format of the server.jar file has changed. This change is made to solve some problems relating to Java modules and means that the libraries used are now bundled individually instead of all being merged. On startup, the application will unpack the libraries into a directory configured by the parameter bundler-repo-dir, which defaults to the working directory. This also changes how you run a different main class, which is now set using the bundler main class parameter. Before we head on into the changes for custom worlds in this version, let me first ask you to please take a moment and trigger the like button, because that makes YouTube show this video to more people, so I do appreciate it. Now, there are also quite a few changes to custom world formats in this version. To begin with, there's also a bug fix for the debug display of the noise values used in world generation, where some biome builder values would simply never change at all. Now, as for format changes, let's begin with feature decorators. Two feature decorators have been removed. They are heightmap spread double and spread 32 above. There are also two new decorators. They are block filter and environment scan. Both of these are based off of a new concept called block predicates, which is a way to specify tests for block data. There are three basic tests and three modifier tests. To start off, there is matching blocks, which takes a list of blocks and an offset. The test passes if the block at the location specified by the offset to the origin of the decoration is included in the list of blocks, otherwise it fails. Another predicate is matching fluids, which looks exactly the same and works exactly the same, but with fluid identifiers instead of blocks. The final primitive test is replaceable. It simply checks that a block has the replaceable property, which is all the blocks you can replace by placing a block in their location in-game, like grass, for instance. Then there are the three derived predicates. Let's start with not, which simply inverts the given predicate. There are also two predicates that combine the results of other predicates, any of, which matches if any of the listed predicates match, and all of, which matches only if all the listed predicates match. Now, these predicates are used in different ways by the two new decorators. The simplest one is the block filter one, which simply aborts feature placement if the given predicate is false. The other new decorator is environment scan. It will start at the origin and try to move in a certain max distance either up or down, looking for a certain environment. The placement is done when a position is found that matches the given predicate, or aborted if no such position is found. Now, as for changes to features, these new decorators are used instead of a bunch of functionality that was previously built into features. The simple block feature has had the place on, place in, and place under fields removed. Where those fields were used, block filter decorators are now used instead. The block placer concept has been removed. Random patches and flowers no longer have block places or state providers, instead they place a delegate configured feature. They also no longer have can replace, project, or need water properties. X spread and Z spread have been merged into a new XZ underscore spread value, and Y spread now also has an underscore in the name. The whitelist and blacklist fields have also been renamed to allowed on and disallowed on. The growing plant feature has been replaced by block column and has been generalized. A block column is a feature that moves in a specified direction from the origin and places any number of layers, where each layer has a height determined by an int provider and a state provider giving the state to place. The block column also has an allow water boolean property and a prioritize tip property. If the prioritize tip property is true, when there isn't enough space to place all of the layers will be cut off from the bottom of the column. If false, layers will be cut off from the top. Finally, there's a new int provider, weighted list. This provider has a single field called a distribution, which is a weighted list of other int providers. The result is first chosen through a randomized lookup in the list, then delegated to the int provider in that slot. And that's it for the tech changes in this version. Thanks to you amazing tech heads for watching all the way to the end, I appreciate it. And while you're here, maybe you'll also want to check out this video. There are now some resources that can only be acquired by trading with the Wandering Trader. So, while you probably never really wanted it before, there's now a good reason to try to get as many Wandering Traders as possible. So, you've picked your spot, let's build it!